Welcome back, Roadrunners.
Today is March 29th, 2018.
And today we have...
Random Facts with London.
A Vine remake.
Guess That Movie.
And much more on this week's Roadrunner Report.
Hey, did you know that snails can sleep up to 3 years?
No, where'd you hear that? Sounds pretty random.
Well, I did get it from Random Facts with London.
What's that?
Pretty much the name. Random Facts with London.
Huh, well, then let's watch the clip. I could use some random facts.
Hey people, today you are watching 20 Random Facts with London. Fact number one, a snail can sleep for more than 3 years at a time. Fact number two, 78% of NFL players go bankrupt after 2 years of finishing their careers. Number three, the number one tire manufacturer in the world is Legos. Number four, Richie Ashburn hit a foul ball that hit a fan in the stands as they were carrying her away. He hit another one, which hit her again. Fun fact, a baseball hit my brother in the head. Fact number five, more than 13,000 years of human life have been spent by watching the Gangnam Style video. Whoop-um, Gundam Style. Fact number six. In 1938, Time magazine named Adolf Hitler Man of the Year. Fact number seven. The average person eats about 60,000 pounds of food in their lifetime. That's six elephants. Fact number eight. There is no word that rhymes with mouth. Fact number nine, the Mississippi River was once flowing backwards after an earthquake. Fact number 10, the ribbon worm will eat itself if it cannot find food. Fact number 11, the first engines put into Fords were made by Dodge. Fact number 12, Jimmy Carter once left nuclear launch codes in his dry cleaning. Fact number 13, cows have the ability to walk upstairs but not down again. Fact number 14, people who measure more intelligence also measure more zinc and copper in their hair. Fact number 15, baby rabbits are called kittens. Fact number 16, the brain cannot create a new face, it only remembers faces you've seen somewhere before. This includes your dreams. Fact number 17, Nachos were invented by a guy named Nacho. 18. 12% of people dream in black and white. 19. Wikipedia banned the Church of Scientology for editing any articles. Fact number 20. Last fact. In 1995, the winner of the 1 million Monopoly game pizza at McDonald's sent it to St. Jude's in an anonymous letter. That is the finishing of watching 20 Random Facts with London. Thank you.
Wow, that was a lot of information.
I know, right? I need to rest my brain.
Well, looking at art always helps my brain rest.
Do you have any art selections in mind?
Well, we had Anthony describe some of the art that students did for the art contest.
Then let's snap to the clip.
Hi, I'm Brennan. I'm also helping host the art awards. Now here's some more art that we've had laid out. Here is a picture by Alina Acuna. One by Christian Gomez Ruiz. Sophia Hutbacher. And then here's another very interesting drawing. It has two sides to it. Clarissa Perez.
It's amazing how people can draw like that.
It really is.
Hey, what was your favorite thing about Pride Week?
I really liked the music on the 3 mile.
Mine was when each run ended because I felt proud that I finished.
Well, there were a lot of different aspects of Pride Week that a lot of different people like, so let's ask them.
So now that Pride Week's over, how do you feel?
I feel really accomplished that I did well on my 3 mile.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with Emily. And the question is, how do you feel about Pride Week now that's over?
I accidentally got a 3-star week, so my legs hurt.
Thank you. Hi, I'm here with
Isaac.
And the question is, how do you feel about Pride Week now that it's over?
I feel good because, like, we've done 3 mile and 2 mile and one. So, like, now that we're done, it feels, like, good not to run and my legs don't hurt.
Thank you. Hi, I'm here with
Tori.
Jocelyna.
And the question is, how do you feel about Pride Week now that it's over?
I feel great. Javier Harris in the background.
Hello, my name is Javier. Thank you for noticing my existence. How I feel about Pride Week? I feel like while it is really stressful and while it can be really exhausting, I think it's a really good initiative of the school to get us in shape.
Okay, thank you. Hi, I'm here with
Dara,
Viti, Haley.
And the question is, how do you feel about Pride Week now that it's over?
Well, at first I thought it was going to be like challenging, but it was better than I expected. It was really good.
Yeah, I thought it would be really hard and a lot to take in, but it wasn't that bad.
Yeah, it was definitely more better than I ever expected it, than all the 8th graders were telling me it was really hard, but it was pretty easy for me.
Thank you.
Speaking of Pride Week, did you see the Pride Week slideshow that eJournalism did?
I was just going to watch that.
Well, I'm going to watch it now if you want to see.
Sure.
Guess what movie love is putting someone else's needs before yours is from?
Well, Frozen, of course.
How'd you know that?
I watched Guess That Quote.
Sounds fun.
I'm Copernicus, and today we're doing Guess That Quote Challenge with Disney movies. I'm here with
Rowan,
Brennan,
Sophie,
Isabella.
All right, the first quote we have is, "The past can hurt, but the way I see it, you can either run from it or learn from it." What Disney movie is that from?
Lion King.
The Little Mermaid.
Toy Story.
It is from Lion King.
Oh.
Hey.
The next quote we have is, "The flower that blooms in adversity is the most rare and beautiful of all." What Disney movie is that from?
A Bug's Life.
Moana.
Mulan.
I don't know.
It is from Mulan.
Should have said Pocahontas.
Alright, our next quote. "You don't have time to be timid. You must be bold and daring." What movie is that from?
The Good Dinosaur.
Toy Story.
Wait, can I get a minute?
The Good Dinosaur.
What do you think? The Good Dinosaur. I don't know.
It is from Beauty and the Beast.
Oh. I knew that.
That was cool. Mm-hmm.
Alright. Next one. You are better than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. What movie is that from?
Bill Nye.
Cars?
Sleeping Beauty.
The Lion King.
It is actually from Winnie the Pooh.
Oh.
That's a movie?
I thought that was a show.
Yeah, there's movies.
Alright, our next quote.
Well, you guys have
our fate lives within us. You only have to be brave enough to see it.
Beauty and the Beast.
Moana.
Snow White.
Pocahontas.
It is from Brave. Alright, our next quote. Sometimes the right path is not the easiest one.
Just go to
him. Toy Story?
Moana.
Guys, is the Wizard of Oz Disney?
It is actually from Pocahontas.
I was gonna say Pocahontas.
Yeah.
Obviously.
See, I knew it. I called it.
The very things that hold you down are going to lift you up.
Come back.
Cars.
Up. What was it again?
The very things that hold you down are going to lift you up.
Yeah, up.
It is actually from Dumbo. The only way to get what you want in this world is through hard work. What's that from?
Jungle Book. Can you skip me for now?
Come back. Snow White.
Cars.
Snow White. Cares.
It is actually from The Princess and the Frog. If you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew you never knew.
Jungle Book.
Up.
Wait, it's getting here.
The Princess and the Frog.
I don't know.
It is from Pocahontas. Life is a journey to be experienced, not a problem to be solved.
Mulan.
Pocahontas.
Pocahontas.
Yeah, Pocahontas.
It is from Winnie the Pooh.
What? This game is hilarious.
It's up to you to know how far you go. If you don't try, you'll never know.
Jungle Book.
Pocahontas.
Wait, skip me real quick.
Cars.
I say cars every time
you shoot. Can you not interrupt my chance to speak? Sleeping Beauty.
It is from The Sword and the Stone. Sometimes we only see how people are different from us, but if you look hard enough, you can see how much we're all alike.
Can you not interrupt me when I am speaking? Come back to me. Pocahontas.
Snow White. I think it's Snow White.
Beauty and the Beast.
I think it's Snow White.
It is actually from Aladdin.
Not because I'm
venture outside your comfort zone. The rewards are worth it.
Jungle Book.
Pocahontas.
Ariel?
I don't know.
The Little Mermaid and
Tangled.
You know, I was just thinking of the Vine remake that a few of our e-journalism students did.
Well, I guess that's gonna test their acting skills.
Then let's cut to the clip.
Oh yes, wait a minute, Mr. Postman!
Hurricane Katrina, more like Hurricane Tortilla.
I wanna be a cowboy, baby.
London, stop walking like that. You're gonna get in trouble. London, stop walking like that. London. Okay.
Wow, that was almost the exact same as Real Vines.
Well, our show's almost coming to an end.
Just like the year.
And after the school year ends,
there'll be a DC trip.
Well, then we'd better inform the 8th graders about what they're getting into.
And there's no better way to inform them than an interview with Mr. Wicklick.
Hi, I'm Nafisa, and I'm with Mr. Ricklick.
And today we'll be talking about 8th grade DC trip.
We are.
So first question is, it's almost end of the year and 8th graders want to end it with fun. So where
they
are
do?
They going?
Why?
I don't know.
Okay. Where are they going? Oh, 8th graders?
Mm-hmm.
Washington, DC, New York, Boston.
So that sounds really fun.
Does it?
Yeah.
Okay.
New York is awesome. So how many years have you been doing this, like running this trip?
7 years. This will be my 8th group. Cut.
I can't. I forgot my glasses.
Here, try these.
I think it's going to be too. Oh, that just...
This is fun.
Okay.
We're going to, yeah, we're going to DC.
Okay.
We're going to have fun.
Do you know the deadlines for 8th graders or 7th graders that want to go to the next trip?
Well, the 8th grade deadline is dead. That means it's pretty much too late. There is room, but it would have to be an amazing thing for you to go now if you're an 8th grader. It does happen sometimes, but the 7th graders, their deadline isn't until next year. Now, we did have some issues with numbers and a bus and stuff. Apparently, World Strides is going to provide another bus since we have such a large group.
If they don't have enough money to go on the trip, what fundraisers can they use?
If they don't have enough money to go on the trip, then they can't go. Oh, no, fundraisers.
Yeah.
Yes, of course we have fundraisers. Every month we'll have fundraisers for like Prime Shine, car washes, and See's Candy, pizza, and I'm drawing a blank here. And every month we have a fundraiser. But it won't pay for the whole trip, so you're going to need to ask your parents and relatives to help pay for that.
And what are the supplies that they need to bring?
Supplies?
Like things that they need to, like...
Clothes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, bring clothes. It's always good to bring clothes. Toothbrush, deodorant, because we don't want to smell your stinky body. I'm not sure. Is that what you're asking? Supplies?
Yeah.
If you've ever traveled, you should know what to bring. And as far as dress code and stuff like that, we're a little lax on the dress code when it comes to traveling because it gets hot and sticky and humid.
So finally, is there anything else that you would like to add?
Oh, it's amazing. You guys who are 8th graders have studied world history. Sorry. You guys who are 8th graders have studied American history and all of your founding fathers and all of the important things that have happened through our country. And you get to see that culminated into one trip in D.C., New York, and Boston. Plus, it's also contemporary things. Some of it's sad, tragic things that have happened in history, but we have a lot of fun doing a lot of things. And of course, many of our students are saying, do we get to go swimming? Yeah, okay, you get to go swimming, big deal. But yes, you can even swim at night after a long day of having fun.
So, well, thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
Information. So we'll
Punch
see
it.
You for the next DC trip.
All right, I'll be there.
That's about it for this week's show.
Good luck to those who have their super mile.
Have a good spring break.
Good luck for next quarter.
And we'll see you next time on the 13th of April
for the Roadrunner Report.
Peace.
And another... Sophia Hootmarker.
Hi, I'm here with...
Alizé.
Kimberly.
Six, seven, and... Skew! No, start over. I wasn't ready.
Good time.